Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'd like to remind you that I have some awesome swag available in some awesome swag stores. I had perhaps a little bit too much fun creating this stuff, but we've got cat themed and pirate themed and Christmas pirate themed Constexpr gear, as well as mugs and classic stuff like likely and unlikely, maybe unused, constexpert, no discard, all of these things. You should absolutely go and check out the swag store and find something to order. There's a fair bit on here. I just had fun creating stuff, so I hope you enjoy it as well. I also have a bunch of puzzle books, including my new Programming Puzzles Big Book. This thing is going to be a spectacular Christmas gift for anyone you know in your life who has any passing interest in puzzles, unique types of puzzles, programming, Python, it has Lisp, it has assembly language, and it doesn't expect you to know any of these things. It teaches you what you need to know as you go along in order with the puzzles. So I really think you'll enjoy this, and I think you should get this for someone in your life. Okay, enough of the shameless self-promotion. I am going to come back to this issue that was opened in 2023, January. All right, so fine. It's been almost 3 years since someone suggested this episode. I'm just now coming back around to it, and the idea is, like, what do you do if you know that you need to only target Windows? And at worst here, even if you want to target only Windows XP. Now, I've actually been planning for quite a while to do a full conference talk about this particular subject. So I'm going to go ahead and just write the answer here. And this isn't going to be very technical. It's not going to be very C++ specific, and it's not going to be a very long episode. The first thing that I would do is I would start by porting the build system to CMake. This, I think, is really very important for making sure that you have any chance of portability whatsoever. Now, your Windows only. But if you can go to a new enough version of Visual Studio, but keep the old compiler, right? Like, you might need to keep an old version of CL.exe. So something like upgrade Visual Studio to the latest. If you need an old compiler, just go ahead. That's okay. You can configure it in CMake. Try to also add a new build that has the latest compiler of CL.exe and another build that is the Clang CL compiler. So try to at least get the thing compiling with Clang if you can. You're probably going to have to turn on a bunch of compatibility things depending on what exactly you need to do. You have now, at this point, ported your build system to CMake, upgraded Visual Studio to the latest thing. Now, the next thing that you need to do is start turning off those compatibility layers. Basically, you want to turn on permissive minus. This is going to be like basically step zero to porting to other compilers and enabling more best practices features. You need to get the code as standards compliant as possible. And this is going to be a good thing no matter what. If you rely on external libraries that rely on Microsoft extensions, isolate that code into a separate module, perhaps a separate static library. This will, again, get you to the point of having a lot of portable code. Now, we're going to take a pragmatic approach to this. You don't want to necessarily port 100% of your code base to Linux or something. Start isolating classes and functions that don't need anything Windows specific at all. And this is definitely going to be possible. Unless you have like 100% like just totally integrated all of the Microsoft things through your whole code base, but hopefully you haven't. Hopefully you can move those things into their own static library with their own test. Now I want you to add a Linux GCC clang, whatever build that compiles and tests just those isolated components. Now you've started, hopefully, to see the advantages here. Newer compilers basically always catch more bugs at compile time, and now that you've started to isolate this stuff out, you should be able to arrange a wider range of newer compilers. You've probably been able to add the ability to have clang tidy checks to most or all of the code base. I'm fully acknowledging that you might need to use an older backend compiler for deployment, but that does not stop you from using newer compilers on your CI. And this is the key takeaway. Your requirements for shipping, they are not the same requirements for CI and development. Your CI and development can almost always use newer tools to catch more bugs, so even if you're supporting Windows XP, you should be able to compile most of that thing on a modern version of Windows with a modern MSVC, modern compilers, catching as many bugs as possible at compile time. But of course, you have to make sure you keep that old toolchain for deployment on your CI to ensure that you've never broken it. This is my recommendation, and I've gone over this discussion and process with many students over the years, and I have had teams that absolutely are limited to old versions of Visual Studio for shipping, but their CI has like Clang 16 or whatever, right? They push it as far as they can on the CI to make sure their code is as good and as clean as possible, but it takes effort to get there, and you can do this incrementally. And I did another recent episode on how to slowly add new warnings, and that is absolutely a part of this conversation as well. This is one step at a time. Turn on the thing, then fix the warning, then turn on the thing, then fix the warning. Basically, don't try to do it all at once. All right, well, thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. I hope this was helpful, perhaps. There's a lot of developers out there that are still developing Windows-only C++ code. And to be fair, even if you think you're developing Linux-only C++ code or macOS-only C++ code, I still recommend that you try to get your code as portable as possible and support as many toolchains and compilers as possible. I'll go ahead and reference this. I have my Thinking Portable talk that I gave at C++ Now in 2016, I think. Thinking Portable, How and Why to Make Your C++ Cross-Platform. This was C++ Now, 2015. This has been more than 10 years, and I will say that the topics discussed here are still 100% relevant, and I do plan to revisit this at some point in a future conference talk. Thanks for watching this episode. I'll catch you in the next one.